to you all. How are you all doing? If you've watched my previous videos, you would know that I'm here at Maranello now, that I'm up to some cool stuff at the moment, visiting Ferrari and Lamborghini factory, and you would have assumed what I'm gonna do today. I'm going to visit Pagani factory. This is exactly why I love this area and so-called supercar valley. I mean, I'm in Maranello where the Ferrari is located, and I had 21 kilometer to Pagani factory, and 21 kilometer probably in another direction is Lamborghini factory, and that's just, I love it. It's all about cars here.
By the way, I'm really excited to see the Pagani factory because apparently it's not that big, but it's really, really unique. Well, there, after all, there might be opportunity to see Horacio Pagani. I heard that he likes to be around. That's also the possibility.
There it is, Pagani. Very nice.
300 meters.
No, I need to. I've reached my destination. And here we are at Pagani. And once again, I'm really inappropriate coming with my Ferrari backpack. But I know that Horacio Pagani has a TDF, so that's kind of fine. So as I can see, it goes from here all the way to there. I think that's a full length.
The minute is full of it, getting pumped up on the little bright things I want. But I know they'll never own me.
With the Pagani Huayra next to me in beautiful red color with exposed carbon and front golden wheels, pretty sick. So, I was given this to be recognized, and let's have a look around. And this is what happens when your tire is wide enough so you can make actual table. I believe that is a clay model of Pagani Huayra. I'm not sure because there isn't anything written around it, so I don't know whether that is actually. Okay, so we're going in now. Unfortunately, no photos obviously, so I'll see you in a bit. And this area here, it's, if you're lucky enough to own one of the Paganis and to buy one, it will be covered here and you would have a very spectacular reveal of your new car before it drives out through those doors. And with that, I'm saying bye-bye to Huayra and to the Pagani factory. So I'll have to continue from here because I was literally kicked out. I was like, I need just 5 minutes to film this, and she was saying yes, but we need to close. So first things first, Horacio Pagani was an Italian. He's originally from Argentina. Second, you've seen the motorcycle, very cool small motorcycle, which he made at age of 15. Then at age of 20, he made a Formula. He must have made that with someone else. If he did it by himself, then that Zonda R Evo, 1070 kilograms and 800 horsepower. I'm not that impressed about the power as much as I am with the weight. Weight is very, very low. I mean, you've seen that everything is carbon fiber. Zonda, meaning of Zonda. Why Zonda? It means wind. And he wanted to reflect back to Argentina. Then in 1999, he made Zonda C12. C meaning Cristina. Cristina is his wife. He wanted to thank her for her support all the way. And 12, obviously meaning 12 cylinders. Zonda F then comes along, F standing for Fangio. Fangio is the racing driver who helped him come here to Italy and start building his dream, so that's a way to thank him as well. And then we move on to Huayra. Huayra meaning god of wind, and it was very much different from Zonda's because firstly it has active aero, you know, the front flaps, the rear spoiler also. There is no visible spoiler, but there are flaps at the back as well which lift and front, and all of them move independently, and when they're not active, they are just in the shape of the body. There is no like additional spoiler. Huayra is the only Pagani that can be sold in States. That's because it's turbocharged and produces less emissions than any other previous Pagani vehicle. And that is pretty sad because if you think about it, any Zonda, any naturally aspirated Pagani can only spend up to 10 days
in states, not more. And also something that we've seen over there is they have to produce two different types of mirrors for Huayra's. One is for European market and one is for states. And then we are entering the actual factory, okay? So we are entering through that small hallway, which is made out of bricks and very, very cool design with the small art windows on the side, and you can see the Huayra BC on the left. It's like you're entering a small castle. It was pretty cool. So entering the main floor, straight away the first thought that came to my mind, this is very similar to Aston Martin Design Studio. And it was. So very, very bright room, very white. And it reminded me of Aston Martin Studio, both in terms of design and size. And the whole room and the building is designed as such that it can rely on a natural light. It's very, very pleasant to be in, as in it's not too bright, it's not too dark. You don't need any other light. When we were in, it was super nice. The whole building is made to resemble like Italian piazza, and that explains the whole thing and the whole design. And they have those lamp posts, they have a brick tower with the old clock at the top. I mean, it is very, very cool. There was definitely not many employees working. There was actually two of them on the main floor around cars, but well, they were kind of on their phones. Anyhow, and come on, when I looked up, there was also a gym, like a small gym for employees. That is just, well done, Pagani. Now, enough of aesthetics, let's talk about the processes. There is no production line, there is no machinery, there is no hydraulic machines which move things around, no. This is like few main stages, and that's it. Firstly, because of the volume that they produce, and secondly, because everything is handcraft. But when I say everything, don't think about everything, because they make only, and I say only and I confirm that, only carbon fiber bits and the assembly of the vehicles. Everything else, whether it's interior or mechanical components or anything is outsourced to suppliers. So we're talking about brakes, Brembo, we are talking about suspension ollies, we are talking about obviously the engine, AMG. They have around 7 people at AMG working specifically only on Pagani engines. So stages. There are 4 main stages. So the first one, where they pretty much combine the front end, the front suspension, the front components with the chassis and the kind of occupant shell, and at the end the engine. So those 3 come together. Then the next one and the next one and the next one, so 3 other. I didn't really see the difference. Almost all 3 cars were almost finished, so I'm not sure what exactly happened, and they didn't explain. To finish one car, it takes about 7 months. Current waiting line is about 2 years. So if you buy one, you'll be waiting 2 years. They aim to produce 40 to 50 cars. I say they aim because they moved to this factory last September, meaning that they still don't know how many exactly they will produce. In the previous factory, they were producing 20 units a year. Also, an interesting car which I've seen inside is just a casual Porsche 911 R sitting there at the back, white with red stripes, of course, and it's Pagani's personal car. Very, very cool. And then we also seen the Zonda Cinque, Zonda Cinque. And now I say 15 times, I don't know, now I mixed it up. Anyhow, we've seen one of those inside, and that was pretty cool because it was 505, so it was the coupe. So they made 5 coupes and 5 roadsters. This one was number 5. And the cool story is that one of the dealers just asked, we want to have 5 unique vehicles for our customers, and then Pagani made 10. Well, 5 and 5. 5 coupes, 5 roadsters. And then that was the end of the tour. And it's a very, very cool place and very different. And trust me when I say that, because I've visited Ferrari and Lamborghini now, and I obviously worked at Aston Martin, so I know what to compare it to. And this is nothing like it. So this shouldn't be called really a factory, because there is no production line, there is no machinery, that heavy machinery which you imagine. And this should be called like a design and assembly studio. That's how we should call it, I think. So if you do visit, do not expect... So if you do visit, don't expect the proper factory. And then, just before leaving, I went to toilet. And this is what happened. No way. I seriously didn't start filming because I was expecting something like, I just wanted to film the doors. This is sick. Look at this. Look at the carbon. Just look at this. crazy, right? It's incredible. Like, it's really gonna seem like I'm mostly impressed by the toilet, but no. But it was just something that I completely didn't expect. I mean, the same way I didn't expect the whole studio to seem like a piazza, like Italian piazza. So that was very, very cool. And I do expect this place to be very beautiful in the future, because there's still a lot of works ongoing and they're still sorting everything out. So I do need to come back in the future at some point to see everything finished, because I think it's gonna be a pure art. And as I call Pagani, art on wheels. So I would expect this to reflect that. And with that being said, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. And if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe, of course. See you in the next one, guys. Bye!